Hello guys, so in this video we are going to prove that omega wedge with eta is same as minus 1 raised to kl eta wedge product with omega, where omega is an element of k form on V and eta is an element of L form of V. So we will prove this result for arbitrary value of k and l, but we start with when k and l is 1. When k and l is 1, we have omega is an element of one fold of V, one form of V, and eta is the same. So if you see the wedge product of omega and eta, by the definition of wedge product, since the wedge product will be going to be in the second form on V, so 2 factorial divided by 1 factorial, 1 factorial alt of omega tensor product with eta. Now we also apply the definition of alt. What is the definition of alt say? Where does this element belong? This element belongs to the second tensor. That means we have to divide it by 2 factorial, then 2 into 1 by 2 factorial summation sigma running or S2 sine of sigma, that thing that is omega tensor product with eta, V of sigma 1, V of sigma 2. We know there are only 2 element in S2, one is identity and one is the one transposition, that is 1 goes to 2. So if we expand this summation, this 2 and 2 will get cancelled, we get omega V1, since for the first element we are taking identity. So sigma of 1 is 1, sigma of 2 is 2, and we have used this tensor, we have used the definition of tensor, it will split over it, and sine of identity is plus 1, so we get plus 1 over here, and sine of the other one, that is transpose 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 1, that is minus 1, so we have minus 1, 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 1, so we get this. And if you see the other way around, that means if you see this product, this wedge product, then you will notice that the definition, in the definition we have to swap these two. That means we have to swap these two, that means we have to swap these two and this two. So ultimately what you get is eta wedge product with omega is same as omega V2 eta V1 minus omega V1 eta V2, which is nothing but exactly opposite in the sign of what we had. Correct. So we get both are opposite in the signs. So for k and l equal to 1, we get the proof really simply. And if we know this, the in general proof becomes simple. As we know, phi I1 wedge product till wedge product with phi ik, where I1, I2, ik, if we go, all are distinct and all running between 1 to n, forms a basis for k form on V. So if you consider any element inside a k form of V, we can write in this term. That means we are writing our omega same as omega 1 wedge product dot 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 wedge product with omega. We have taken k wedge products where each of the omega i's are element of one form on V. Similarly, we can work on this eta also. Eta is same as eta 1 wedge product dot dot dot, and then we go for a wedge product with eta l. So finally, if we come to our result, that is when k and l are arbitrary, you can see that omega wedge product with eta can be written as all of those wedge product together. Now by using this property, we know whenever we have one form and whenever we interchange, sign will change by 1, right, minus 1. Okay, so if I take this till this, that means I have to swap how many times? 1, 2, 3, I have to swap k times, then only my eta 1 will come on the first place. So I have wrote minus 1 raised to k, everything as it is, my eta 1 has came to first place and everything is shifted by 1. Okay, similarly what I do is my omega 2 will come on the second place. So how many times it has to change? It has to change its place with k omegas, right? So I have added plus k to the power of minus 1. So I got minus 1 raised to k plus k, that is 2k, omega 1 wedge product with, eta 1 wedge product with eta 2 wedge product with omega 1, and then so on. If we continue this process, what we are going to do, we are going to take each of these etas first and each of the omega at the end. So at the end, what you are going to, how many etas you are going to bring in the front, there are L such, and for each of them you have to make k swapping, right? So we get k into l as a power of minus 1, and hence you get this. In this, if you notice, this will be nothing but your eta wedge product with omega, and which is nothing but our required answer. Thank you so much for watching this video.